Presented by Church Tech U, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, how to use timers and countdowns in ProPresenter 7. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I help you learn all about ProPresenter. My name's Paul Allen Clifford. One of the things that we've done for years and years is have countdowns in ProPresenter. Maybe you're new and you've never done it before. Well, I hope this lesson will help you. But if you're not, you probably think you know all there is to know about doing countdowns. You've done it the same way for years. Well, you can still do that in Pro 7, but you've got a couple of extra options. Options that I just really picked up on recently that you may not know about. So let's take a look and see what those options are. So first off, what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to go into timers and add a timer. I got a bazillion of these things here. It says 6, but that's only because that's the 6th one that's not named something different. So you add a timer by clicking this plus button here, and then you can give it a name. Let's just say newest timer, just to separate it out from some of the others. And we've got 3 options here. Number 1, countdown timer. That would be if you want to do a 5-minute countdown. Works perfectly fine unless you get to the computer with 4 minutes for service to start. Then it gets a little wonky. So countdown a specific amount of time, it works. But I think the second option is even better, and that's countdown to a time. So if you know that church starts at 10 a.m., that's when my first service starts at my church, then I could have the countdown timer go to 10 a.m. But if I want to fudge it a little bit and let people have an extra couple of minutes, I could have it go to 10:02 a.m., not p.m. That would be like 12 hours and 2 minutes. So I could do a countdown to a time. The third one is an elapsed time. You're probably not going to use this very often, but it might be useful on the stage screen to show how long service has lasted or how long the pastors preach, you know, things like that. So that's what the third one's for. We're just going to leave this at countdown to a time. Now, I've got that set to 7 p.m. I could also do a.m. or 24-hour clock. The overrun checkbox here says, okay, when it's at 000, what happens? Does it either stop at 000 or disappear? Or does it overrun, like start going positive? So if it was counting down, now it starts counting up. That would be what the overrun does. This restarts the timer, so if you had the 5 minutes and you know you just needed to restart it, you could do that, and this starts it from the beginning. So that's where you create the timers. Now, the traditional way that we've been doing this since probably at least Pro 3, I think, is to put the timer in a message so that it sits above the slides layer and everything like that. So what we do is we click on messages, and by default, it'll look like that. So click on this little pencil icon here, and then you need to create a new message. So I'm going to create a new message, and I've got these tokens over here. They're like variables in math. So I know the newest timer was the one that I just did, so I can just drag that over, and it will show me the default information here. And what I can do is that would just be the timer showing up that way. Or I can type something like service starts in, and the timer will change while the service starts in part will remain constant. Before I put it in, I can select a theme. So let's do this. I like the lower third new one. That's one I created recently. Dismiss manually, I'm saying, do when it gets to 000, do I just let it sit there until I remove it? Or I can also do after the timer expires. So when it reaches 000, it just disappears. I could also do it after a certain amount of time, but I find that one a little less useful, although there are certain circumstances where you might want to use that. So I've got the timer. If I decided the countdown to a time was the wrong thing, I have total control. I don't have to go back into timers up here to change that. I can change it right here. If I wanted to change the time, you know, if the worship pastor says, hey, can we make that 7:02? No problem. I can do that. So once I do that, I can just click show, and there it is. Easy breezy lemon squeezy, and that'll continue to go until this runs out. And then at 000, since I've got it set to manually, I would have to remove it, which I could do by clicking here. I could also put an action on a slide to do that. So right click and go into add actions. And remember, that was a message that I put in. So let's go under actions palette. And so what I'm going to want to do is find the message icon here and drag that onto, let's say, this slide. And now I just need to find the message that I just created, message one, and click done. And now as soon as I click on that slide, it shows up. So I could absolutely put that on my pre-service loop and the message would show up there. You'll see it's down here as well. So that's one way to do it. And that was our only choice through ProPresenter 6. Now let me show you two other ways that they've added with ProPresenter 7. So the next thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to add it on a prop. So let's go into the props editor. And let's see here, that's it. So I already added a prop by clicking the plus button. Then I added a text box. Okay, and then I clicked on the text box and I clicked on linked text. Here, let me make myself disappear there. And under choose type, I chose a timer and then I selected the newest timer. So let me go ahead and delete that and click on it just so that you can see right there. Now, I have some options here. I can by default, it's set like this, where 2 hours, 2 minutes places, 2 seconds places, and 2 fractions of a second's place. Let's say I don't want those, I can just click that and that goes away. You'll notice that down here the example reflects that. Also, let's say that I don't like the way that this looks. So what I can do is tweak the text over here. So do that. Maybe I want to add an outline around the text. So it's probably too big, but something like that, and then I'm good to go. So now, if I go into props, and again, I can add this with an action. There's a props action, basically the same as the message action. Or I can just click on that, and you'll notice that this is going, and it's got exactly the same thing up here. So why is that valuable? Well, you'll notice that we have the ability to remove messages and props separately. So let's say that I had two different countdowns for one reason or another. I could remove one and not the other. Let's say that I wanted to put a message up that didn't include the countdown, and then I wanted to remove that but not remove the countdown. I could have the props countdown stay and then remove the message. So that removed the prop, that removed the message. So that's a second way to do it. A third way is, let's say you've got a pre-service loop and just announcement slides up there, but sometimes you don't want the counter up there. You want it to only show up on certain slides. Let's say you're playing a video and you just think it's distracting to have that up there during the video. Well, what you can do is you can add it on the slide itself. So if we right-click here and go to edit slide, or we can click on editor up here, either way. So the process is very similar to how we added it on the prop. We add a text box, and then we click on linked text. We choose a timer, and we choose our latest timer. Then I can format that just like I did before. And then I go to show, and as I click on it, then it shows up there. So just as it did here for this message. And notice that since the message is above the slides layer, that stays no matter what slide I'm on. But this one only shows up when I'm on this slide. So, see? And they remain in time with one another, just like that. So that is the three ways of adding timers in ProPresenter 7. If you like this content, I bet you'd like my Pro 7 Quick Start course. So just head on over to tdm.fyi/pro7quick. Put in your name and email address, and then I'll create a login for you automatically where you can watch those videos, leave comments, etc. So it's a legitimate course that I've made just for you. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.